since the Beatles' first record was released.
Yeah, Matt and I weren't even around then. But as Carrie discovers, their debut single didn't exactly set the world alight.
Today, they're still the most famous pop band of all time. Every year, hundreds of thousands flock to Liverpool to pay their respects.
All of this may never have existed. Fans stand or fall by that first single, and most don't get a second chance. When the Beatles released Love Me Do, it simply wasn't that popular. It didn't make them rich or famous.
In fact, it only reached number 17 in the charts. It was Please Please Me, released the following year, that shot straight to number one. In retrospect, Love Me Do has been seen as the Beatles' false start. At the time, record shops didn't stock up with many copies, and not even those closest to the band were particularly optimistic about its success. Iris Caldwell, only 17 at the time, was Paul McCartney's girlfriend.
So when the first single, Love Me Do, came out, were you thinking, well, they're going to be huge?
No.
Really?
Really.
I can't believe that.
I know, isn't that ridiculous? It was, you know, they've had a lucky break and it was, yeah, it was all right, that record sort of thing.
Love Me Do was the single that was out when you guys were dating at the height of your... I'm thinking romance, perhaps not romance, I'm thinking romance. So was it about you?
I don't think so. He said to me once, you know, can't write a song about you, Iris. I said, why? He said, because the only thing that rhymes with Iris is virus.
But for one of the Beatles, the first single would be the cause of another false start. Love Me Do would mark both the beginning and end of drummer Pete Best's recording career with the band. Peter joined in 1960 after meeting the Beatles in his mum's coffee club, the Casbah, and they'd spent 2 years hard slog touring Germany together before getting their big break, a chance to record a single at the Abbey Road Studios in London. They had four songs in mind.
Beso Me Mucho, Ask Me Why, P.S. I Love You, Love Me Do. Played them. Thought no more about it at that time. It was just to basically give the sound guys, the A&R men, and George Martin what our portfolios. Little did I know at that time that I wouldn't be going back to the next recording session.
In a ruthless move, George Martin booked a session musician to play drums on Love Me Do, and Best was edged out of the band.
There was a lot of confusion that had been turned around and said that, okay, the A&R guys couldn't handle my sound because of a very powerhouse drummer, big sound.
How do you feel about that?
At that time, very angry. 2 years I'd been with them, we'd performed, I'd taken them from a mediocre band, developed a sound, given them a drum sound which was absolutely unique. It was nicknamed the Atom Beat. A lot of drummers in Liverpool copied it, even Ringo, even though he denies it, you know, but that's between him and me for a future date.
Meanwhile, Ringo Starr was waiting in the wings, playing in a band fronted by Iris's brother, Rory.
My brother was only paying him £25 a week and the Beatles offered 30. And sadly for Pete Best, I mean, that was the real tragedy of the whole thing.
How does it make you feel hearing the single today?
Same as it did 50 years ago, basically, you know. A bit of pride because of the work you'd put into it, but a little bit of sadness because it wasn't your version and you weren't part of it.
Love me do. You know I love you. Always be true. So
Love Me Do may not have been their best song, but what it did do was showcase their energy and their charm and their brand new take on what pop music should sound like. And that influenced musicians for decades. As John Lennon said, this song gave us somewhere to go.
Great stuff. Well,